It's not been long dead, boss.
I'll be waiting until nightfall. Excellent. Let's see what we can discover. I'll have a look around the main hall while you investigate the library. Look for anything you think is out of place.
Don't trip, yes?
Did you find anything? Interesting. This is a personal letter from Lord Macnarian to his wife. Niles Macnarian was the benefactor who paid for and oversaw the construction of the original sections of the building. It looks as if the seal was broken a long time ago, perhaps delivered and then recovered by the original sender. Whatever its fate, the letter almost certainly has something to do with the ghostly presence around here. Let's keep looking about, but do be careful. I think the spirit is starting to become agitated. Several weapons fell off the walls right behind me, and many of the dishes in the reception hall flew off the table and landed at my feet. I'm a bit tired, to be honest. Trying to attune my senses to an unknown specter has really taken its toll. I think I'm going to go have a lie down in the staff barracks for a couple hours. I suggest you use one of the other beds in there and get a little rest as well. We're going to need to stay sharp. Good, you're awake. You have to come see this. Oh yes, the mannequins seem to have come to life on their own and have come up from the armory and begun to wander around the museum, while their compatriots have apparently barricaded themselves in from the other side. But no, this is actually what I wanted to show you. I can't explain it beyond saying there's definitely something awry here. They're trying to get our attention, but what exactly are they trying to say is beyond me. I'm gonna go take a look around the East Exhibit Halls. Why don't you search the Gallery of Natural Science? And I believe there's a storeroom under the staff barracks that might be worth searching.
Yeah!
Some Nord warriors flow through my veins.
There certainly is an ethereal presence here. Did you find anything? Interesting. Well, it's clear that we're dealing with the disquieted spirit of Lord Bagnarian himself. Though I'm not exactly sure why he would be upset. The hall had always been named for him, prior to it being a museum. That's a distinct probability. The journal makes mention of a portrait of him that was commissioned. Do you recall ever seeing such a painting hanging in the museum? Maybe you should have a look around the museum and see if you can find if it's been stashed away anywhere. I believe that if we could find it and put it prominently on display, it would appease the ghosts and he would stop harassing people. Excellent.
Hey, that looks like fun. Do it again. Don't trip, yes?
Quite an interesting place this building is. A lot of history here. You did? That's superb. Let's hang it up in the reception hall. Huh. There certainly is an ethereal presence here. Great. And now we rest. By morning, I suspect all this unpleasantness will be over. But we should spend the night here just to make sure there's nothing else the spirit is looking for. Oh, good. You're awake. Are you all right, my friend? When I woke up, you were gone from the barracks and lying unconscious out here on the floor. Well, I should say so, and it had a good solid hold on you, to be sure. I suspect it was no mere nightmare, but Magnarian himself. The feelings and thoughts of the dead often come to the living as very disturbed. We believe it's only because they lack the means to fully make their wills known. Did you discover anything? Oh, this is terrible. I had heard that Lord Magnarian had met a rather unfortunate end after his wife passed away. But I didn't know the circumstances until now. And by the look of this journal, he was in great grief right before his death. I must have plummeted to his death from the cliff out back. If you're up to it, I suggest looking around for any clues. I seriously doubt that there will be any out there, as this has all happened decades ago, but you never know. And our work is obviously not finished with the placing of the painting. I saw that there is a way to access the alley between the Blue Palace and the museum on the upper balcony. Here's a ladder I found amongst the clutter that the ghosts scattered about. Just be careful out back. We wouldn't want you to share in Magnarian's fate.
Who's this, boss? Sure. Got anything good, boss? Yes, boss.
We're one of the same. If that is what you wish. Lead on, then.
This place certainly can put one on. Did you find anything? Amazing. To think that this small bit of parchment has been wedged between the rocks, dangling from the cliffs out there all this time, being ravaged by the winds and the rain and the snow year after year, and it still persisted. Perhaps it was the will of Niles Magnarian that preserved it so we might take action on it. Burgess Ulfstead, is it? Ulfstead, where have I... Ah, that's right. There's a stonecutter by that name living down by Catla's farm. Or Morgrain, if memory serves. I'd take it to him and see what you can find out about what happened to the statue his great-great-grandfather carved.
Looks like they are dead.
Can I help you with something? Gondrak, what's this?
Oh dear, this is my great-great-grandfather's name. He was a sculptor and a stone cutter by trade. Passed down through the family to me as well. So after 3 generations, are you finally here to make good on this and collect the statue?
Well, yes, it's been gathering dust in our cellar for ages. None of us had the heart to sell it since great-great-grandfather apparently didn't feel right about selling it because it was half paid for already. Absolutely. I'll get some hands and we'll cart it on up there by tomorrow.
Breathing.
Well, my friend, it seems that did the trick. It hasn't exactly removed the spirit per se, but it certainly has appeased him. I found last night that the spirits of both Niles and Aurelia were wandering the halls of the museum, admiring the displays and taking in the splendor of the building Niles worked so hard on. They seem quite content. You may see them around from time to time in the late hours of the night, but I wouldn't expect any further problems. Not at all. Just doing the good work of our case so that the spirits of the deceased get the rest they deserve, and the rest of us can manage to get a good night's sleep as well. Take care. Ah, hello again. I trust no more ghosts have taken hold of the museum.
You think I did it?
Ah, yes. This is much easier. Good.
How can I help?
Oh dear, excuse me.
Do you have a question? Ah, yes, that was a bit of unsettling business now, wasn't it? I kept being awakened by strange voices in the museum and found that the pages of my books by my bed would be turning on their own and decided to call the aid of the priest of Arke. I took refuge at the Blue Palace in the meantime. Thank you for looking into it.
Also, I'm to understand that you paid out of pocket for the statue out front, which appeased the spirit. I'll reimburse you for that.
See you around.
Don't fall over, boss.
Seems there's no end. Needs of the Imperials. But what can I help you with? Wanderer like you must have plenty tales to tell. But I'm afraid I'm too busy to hear them. I got some fine arm. Looking. Seems there's no end to the needs of the Imperials. But what can I help you with? Blades, helmets, pretty much anything to suit your needs. Return anytime you need arms or armor. My forge.
Hello there. Seems there's always more to be done.
So, what do we have here? Let me guess. By your scent, I'd say you were from the Guild. But that can't be true, because I told Mercer I wouldn't deal with them anymore. I don't deal in land or property. Now, if you're looking for goods, you've come to the right person. Oh, wait. Did you say Golden Glow Estate? My apologies. I'm sorry to say I know very little about that bee farm, was it? Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. I can't be expected to remember every deal I handle. I don't care what you promise. If I tell you the buyer's name and word gets around, it can ruin me. Well, now that you mention it, there is something I've been trying to get my hands on. I have a buyer looking for a case of Firebrand wine. There just so happens to be a single case in the Blue Palace. Bring it to me, and we'll talk about Golden Glow Estate.
We get into a fight, maybe? Don't mind me, boss.
Need something?
Ah, I see you have the wine. Hand it over, and we'll talk. Good. Can't have the buyer getting impatient and looking elsewhere for this, can we? Here, take this. I certainly can't use it, but I suppose I need to pay you something for the goods. Not at all. I consider it an investment in prolonging my life. As far as Golden Glow Estate goes, I'll tell you what I know. I was approached by a woman who wanted me to act as the broker for something big. She flashed a bag of gold in my face and said all I had to do was pay Arengoth for the estate. I brought in the coin and walked away with her copy of the deed. Not at all. I tend not to ask too many questions when I'm on the job. I'm sure you understand. However, I did notice she was quite angry, and it was being directed at Mercer Frey. In this business, we rarely deal in names. Our identity comes from how much coin we carry. Look, that's all I know. I never promised you I'd have all the answers. Now, since our transaction is done, I'll be on my way.
The dragon. Comes.
Seems there's always more to be done.
Power of the ancient Nord art. Believe.
If you must venture southwest, stay clear of Volskyk. It's a cursed place, a tomb where the dead still live.
Maybe we should have taken the carriage.
Fancy yourself an alchemist, huh? Never could get the hang of that.
You challenge a Nord warrior? Come on! Give me a real challenge!
so much nice stuff in here.
Now, ain't this a surprise?
Over here!
Come on! Give me a real challenge!
Have you! This is what you want, boss!
Die to die, hero!
I can hear the sound of your gold. What did you do to me?
Come on!
life and I will give you a quick death.
An old woman's purse.
I'll mount your head on my wall.
Victor goes this book. Fall over, boss?
No need to do anything rash. This isn't as bad as it seems. I was gonna tell Mercer about everything, honestly. Please, he'll have me killed.
You're dead!
I see you wish to be reasonable. Perhaps I misjudged you. The name of the person you want is Carlaya. Mercer never told you about her? Carlaya is the thief responsible for murdering the previous guildmaster, Gallus. Now she's after Mercer. Help! No, no! Look, I didn't even know it was her until after she contacted me. Please, you have to believe me. I don't know. When I asked her where she was going, she just muttered, "Where the end began." Here, take the Golden Glow estate deed as proof. And when you speak to Mercer, tell him I'm worth more to him alive. Gods, another fight.
We're one of the same kind, you and I. I'm glad you have met me.
You needed to know more. Needed to know more.
What did you need?
Interesting. Yeah, some jobs.
How about you?
Gullamai works. That means he isn't exactly in the guild, but he pays us a cut of all the stuff he lifts from the warehouse.
Can I do anything for you? Or more to the point, to you?
Vipper, the fleet. The only man who's foolish enough to name himself after his bedroom flowers.
Stupid cow. You don't know what you're missing.
No, but I know that you're going to turn up missing if you keep up this kind of talk.
What do you need?
Did Gullamai give up any information on our buyer? No, it can't be. I haven't heard that name in decades. This is grave news indeed. She's someone I hope to never cross paths with again. Carlia destroyed everything this guild stood for. She murdered my predecessor in cold blood and betrayed the guild. After we discovered what she'd done, we spent months trying to track her down, but she just vanished. Carlia and I were like partners. I went with her on every heist. We watched each other's backs. I know her techniques, her skills. If she kills me, there'll be no one left that could possibly catch her. If only we knew where she was. There's only one place that could be. The place where she murdered Gallus. A ruin called Snowvale Sanctum. We have to go out there before she disappears again. Yes, I'm going with you, and together we're going to kill her. Here's your payment for solitude. Prepare yourself and meet me at the ruins as soon as you can. We can't let her slip through our fingers.
Well, looks like you're fitting in well down here. I'm supposed to allow you to trade in one of your pieces of guild armor. So what will it be? Of course. Otherwise it wouldn't be much of a reward, now would it? Your new piece will enhance your skill beyond that of the original. Trust me. Are you sure? Once I exchange it for you, I'm not taking it back. Unless you want to sell it at a discount, of course. Okay, there you go. Welcome to the I give special rates to members of the Thieves Guild. Show me what you've got. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Still have quite a good bit of jobs available, if you're looking for some extra coin. Well, well. I was looking for this little beauty. If you happen across any other unusual trinkets like this, be sure to bring them to me. I promise it'll be worth the effort. This should compensate you for your fine. What's the matter? Afraid of getting your hands dirty?
Hello, child of kin. I'll gladly share my knowledge with you.
Yes? What is it? Fantastic, then.
Huh. How's your day faring? Goodbye, then.
Guildmaster.
Mm-hmm. All right, then.
Good day, Fred. Yes? Sure. What can I help you with? Sounds good. I'll be back in a few days. What can I do for you, Guildmaster?
Back. Wonderful. I trust things fare well. I found an odd weapon from a Dunmer trader, and it turned out to be something rather impressive. Here, have a look, and place it on display if you like.
What can I do?
Thank you.
I've been looking for you. Got something I'm supposed to deliver. Your hands only. Let's see here. Looks like that's it. Got to go.